At this time, I'd like to bring up the Director of the Department of Natural Resources, David Mustine.
Thank you, Jim. I just had a couple of comments I wanted to make. First of all, glad to be here today. Thanks for having us. You know, as I've got my head around the Department of Natural Resources over these last 7 months, one of the areas that was a real challenge for me was really the soil and water. I'm looking at Ted, our chief back there, Ted Lozier. You know, trying to understand the mission of the group, and there's a lot of different responsibilities there, and then how it kind of fits into everything else. And it is an important part of our department. We, as you know, we have a very broad remit in Department of Natural Resources. But it was interesting for me to kind of get a better understanding of how soil and water fits in and relates to the ag community here in Ohio. And I, you know, certainly understand how important the ag business is and agriculture is to our economy. So as we look at that connecting point on this issue of our soil and water group, how we interact with the soil and water districts, the kinds of services that we are offering them, and making sure that our resources are being put in the highest and best value to the state of Ohio and to groups like those represented today, to make sure that we're being very much a customer service oriented organization. On this particular issue, there's at least two other connecting points for our department. And one is our coastal group, and some of you may be familiar with that, but we have a group that's actually very involved in the submerged lands that the state of Ohio is responsible for in Lake Erie. So development along Lake Erie is something we get involved in and have a role to play. As a consequence, we understand what are some of the developmental challenges and opportunities along the lake. So development along the lake, property development is very important and a very big part of the economy along Lake Erie. And then the third connecting point is really in the kind of the recreation side and resource side when you look at wildlife and the responsibility of for our anglers of making sure we have a healthy walleye and yellow perch population in Lake Erie. You all know the numbers. This is a very significant business activity for our state and also a high for our quality of life. And then in addition to that, this summer I've had a good opportunity to be on the lake a few times and see some of the fantastic park assets that we have, both our assets in the state of Ohio as well as others. And then you see how important that is to the state. So my message is the phosphorus issue is critical to so many different industries in our state. And we have the Lake Erie Commission, and we think that that's an opportunity to use that very effectively to look at these kinds of issues, consider the economic impact of them, making sure that we're putting our resources in the place that can add the most value. So I'm glad to be here today. Look forward to working with Director Zeringer, Nally, and all of you that are represented as we tackle this major issue. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, David. It reminded me, I was down in Florida 2 weeks ago, and five beaches were posted advisories, and it was due to development and pet runoff. And I thought, well, that's some interesting challenges, but development is a big issue that sometimes gets overlooked. But we as the agriculture community want to focus on agriculture. There, we can point fingers to septic tanks, we can point fingers to everything else, but we need to take charge of our own destiny.